you did all this.
You're one of the dames, I see. Well, you'd best be back to the Vale before the sun sets. Once the men of the garrison have filled their bellies with liquid courage, a brooch won't stay their tempers.
It's not been half a moon since Ben's.
Heard the bones fell favourably. To the Vale, then.
I don't know how a bearer came by the moon and stars, but thank goodness I found you. Can I trust you to be discreet?
About what?
About this. About what I wish to ask of you. About the fact that I, a humble creature, assist the Dame of the Vale in her endeavors. As unlikely as it may seem, there are those within the upper echelons of Sambrequois society who find the Empire's treatment of bearers to be barbaric.
All right. But what do you want from me?
This town is carried upon the backs of its bearers, and yet many would see their servants starve. Not for the want of coin. Simple fare costs little more than a pittance. But to revel in the suffering of others. A simple act of cruelty. Contemptible though it is, my countrymen would sooner cut off their noses to spite their faces than see their bearers fed. And despite my best attempts at secrecy, my efforts to dole out comestibles have been noticed. Which brings me to my request. The brand upon your cheek affords you a certain freedom, a freedom I could sorely use.
Fine. What do you need me to do?
Oh, thank you. An extra meal may not seem like much, but it will make all the difference. Here, deliver these, but keep them hidden. Quickly now. What food I can provide goes where the need is greatest. And today, that happens to be the barracks. Three bearers, overworked and underfed, not permitted a moment's rest.
It's no wonder so many die before their time.
Tragic, true, but do not let anger make you careless. People will view this act of mercy as an undermining of the Empire's authority. Be discreet for both our sakes, and for the sake of those we feed. Oh, and when you're finished, a word in the ear of one of the Dame's girls would be appreciated.
You won't be staying, then?
I'm afraid not. I am expected back in the capital, and have already risked much speaking with you this long.
Crystal's curse is bad enough. We can't let people starve as well.
Heard the bones fell favorably.
Are you waiting for it to heal on its own? Hurry up!
Looks like now's not the time.
Sergeant's got it in for us two. As if either of us needs to brush up on our swordcraft.
He wouldn't doubt our swordcraft if he'd seen us down the Vale last night.
Where's your commanding officer, Branded? Don't you know the training grounds are for real soldiers?
Hey, you lost us something. Sorry, but the Imperial Guard's got no use for your kind. The infantry always needs more bodies, though.
I'm just passing through.
I don't bloody believe it. The bastard's wearing the moon and stars.
That'll be why he's strutting about like he owns the place.
The Dame laughed when we offered her our protection. You reckon this prick's really worth a couple of the Emperor's finest?
I dare say there's ways of finding out. How about it, Branded? Care to show us how you earned that brooch?
I'd rather not.
Oh, no doubt. Only chivalrous souls that we are, Robin and I need to know the dame's being properly looked after.
Fine. If it'll put your mind at ease.
Oh, and just so you know, I won't be holding back. I suggest you don't either. Take a moment to get ready if you need it. Wouldn't want you whining about an unfair fight. Now, let's get the measure of you, shall we?
If that's what you want.
Cocky bastard. All right, let's be having you. Oh, and when you go crying to your mistress, tell her it was Leon who gave you the pounding. Use all the dirty tricks you want, Brandon. All right? So you know one end of a blade. Enough. Fuck me.
What the hell are you playing at, Leon? Ah, so it's a real challenge he wants, is it? Fine. Sword up, bearer. Let's have some fun, shall we? How the bearer win the dame's favor anyway?
By knowing when to hold my tongue for a start. Can I go now?
Grieger's gash. The bastard didn't even break a sweat.
The dame's man or no, he's still a branded. Best hope the sergeant never hears about this.
Yeah, not after the bullocking he gave us for missing drills. Might be the old sod had a point.
I'll leave you to it.
Yeah, good bloody riddance. At least we know the dame's in safe hands, I suppose.
Do us a favour. If you have to tell the dame about this, tell her we got a good few hits in, eh? On second thought, maybe don't mention this to the dame. We wouldn't want you getting into trouble for brawling now, will we?
It's not been half a moon since Bellamy's tour.
I have something for you.
From the Chamberlain. Thank you. You need to leave. Now. Please.
Branded! Who told you to arrest? Stoke those damn flames! And you! If you've got a message for me, out with it. If not, return to your post.
Thank you.
You look like you need a rest. Not half as much as I need this. Thank you. I don't eat it here, though. Not where anyone might see.
Has it always been this bad?
Oh, it was worse before the Chamberlain. I'd be dead without him. Me and many others.
That's something at least.
Enough! Curse you! Get away from me! You'll work faster next time if you know what's good for you!
Here. It looks like you need it.
The Chamberlain must have sent you. But alas, my work is far from over. If I don't go now, they'll beat me.
You need to rest.
But I won't. I've wounds to heal and bones to mend.
And what of your own hurts?
They'll wait. As will my hunger. Thank you, though.
A drover has more regard for his cattle than the Empire does its bearers. Anyway, I'd better head to the Vale.
That bastard! Accident my arse!
The markets are a veritable midden, teeming with vermin.
For business or pleasure?
Business, though not my own. The Chamberlain put me to work delivering food.
Ah, so he found someone to help him then. Just as well. I hear his friends back at court have been taking a little too much interest in him of late.
So he really is a Chamberlain?
There was a time when he was the Vale's most illustrious customer. Us girls thought of him as a generous uncle. He was one of the only people round here who seemed bothered by the way the Empire treats its bearers.
Rare for one in his position.
A fact not wasted on the dame. A little nudge from her is all it took, and he became the patron saint of Northreach's starving masses. My sisters and I may have lost an uncle, but bearers are being fed for a change, so we don't grumble. Much.
Glad to hear it.
Gives you faith, though, doesn't it? To know there are people out there like him. And you, for that matter. It's no wonder the dame's got a soft spot for you.
I better be going.
I haven't seen you around the Vale of late. Don't tell me you've grown tired of us.
It's not that. The garrisons are being called back to the capital.
Tatienne was... is very special to me. All of my girls.
Heard the bones fell favourably.
I'm looking for a man with a scar over his eye.
Looking for a man? Does this look like a brothel, Branded? Fuck off!
Hold your tongue. He wears the Dame's brooch. One word from him and the Vale's doors will be barred to us for good.
There's only one man in the garrison with a dodgy eye. His name's Yannick. I haven't seen him around lately, though.
On account of him being in war. Yeah, Yannick left a few days back. Said he had dealings with a merchant there.
The Dame thanks you. Moor is the last village on the right to Oriflam. I should let Isabel know where I'm headed.
Fools there nigh on every night.
You bear good tidings.
That remains to be seen.
Oh, Tatian, you could have told me.
This Yannick. The soldiers I spoke to believe he's in the village of Moor. According to them, he claimed to have some business with a merchant there. Though that wouldn't explain his continued absence.
And you plan on traveling to Moor to ascertain the truth?
Isn't that what you want?
Oh, it is, but I fear sending you there may cause more harm than good. The people of Moor are rather set in their ways. You'll find they have little love for bearers, and they will not hesitate to report one such as you to the constabulary. There is a man in Moor who owes me a favor, more than one, in fact. His name is Bertrand, and he works at the stables. Tell him I send you.
I shall return as soon as I find something.
Bertrand was a loyal patron of the Vale, until his appetite exceeded his means. Now he is loyal to me.
One of the Dame's pets. Why must she let them off the leash?
These crystals here are for citizens only. There's none for the likes of you.
The Dame may have given you leave to walk freely about Northridge, but one step outside these walls and you'll just...
Oriflam. How many bearers suffer to keep your granaries full?
That's enough for today, Branded.
Enough dallying, you two. Up, the lot of you. There's still work to be done.
You, Brandon, here, now. You're late. What kept you?
Late for what?
Did they tell you nothing? A wild beast is savaging my boy. Well, don't just stand there gawping. Rescue him.
All right. Where is he?
My. I see they've sent me a Branded with a spine for a change. He's over that way, towards the coast. Go and see that you kill the beast. My boy is being attacked. He's not far from here, over towards the coast. Go on and help him, damn you!
For someone whose son's in mortal danger, he didn't seem all that worried. Something's not right here.
I need to be careful.
The wolf! It's going to eat me!
Not if I can help it. Stay back. I'll deal with this.
Stay down! It's over!
Supposed to kill Wolfie. You are supposed to die. Father will have you whipped for this. Bearers aren't supposed to win. They never win.
What is this? Your father said you were being attacked.
You're not supposed to talk. Stop looking at me like that. We were only having fun.
Having fun?
Why are you still speaking? Father will hear of this.
The wolf's work, no doubt. But it's not the wolf that's to blame. Someone needs to put an end to this before it happens again.
Come here this instant. How dare you frighten my son? You slaughter his poor pet and then have the gall to return, head held high. That wolf was trained. Better trained by far than your worthless kind. You are the entertainment, nothing more. And we are most certainly not. Entertained.
Nor am I. You'll pay for what you've done.
See? I told you, he talks too much. It's not right. I don't like him, Father.
You're not the Branded I bought, are you? How dare you deceive me? Well, the sins of the slave are the sins of the master. Go! Summon the unlucky wretch you answer to.
That unlucky wretch would be the dame. I can summon her if you like. Though I doubt she would welcome the interruption.
You serve the dame? Why would a woman of her caliber...
You look afraid. Well, how do you think those bearers in the field felt? Can you imagine their fear? Their pain? From the look of you, I'd say you're starting to get an idea of the first. Now, if you need help with the second...
Father, he's scaring me.
You think to threaten us, Branded? The dame's pet or no, I will not abide such insolence.
Can't we just buy another hound? A bigger one, a better one?
Of course, my son. I'll have the villagers fetch us another. With jaws powerful enough to nip this Branded's head clean off his shoulders.
I'm wasting my time, but I can't just leave those bearers lying out there. They deserve a proper burial. That much I can do at least. How many bearers have lost their lives to this nobleman's sport?
Now to find you a new wolf. heavy. These peasants must have one chained up somewhere.
Then we can play again.
Victims of the nobles' games. You must be Clive.
How do you know my name?
The dame. I'm in her service, like yourself. Never gets any easier, burying the dead.
Is that what you're here to do?
The mistress has me see to it that none are left to the crows. Since you're here, can you give me a hand?
Gladly. Let's put them to rest.
May their burden finally be lifted. I take it you slew the nobleman's pet?
I did. Now I expect they'll find another soon enough. And when it gets here, more bearers will die. How can they think so little of sending us to the slaughter?
Simple. Because you are not them. Bearers are tools when they're needed, and toys when they're not. And if one breaks, well, you can always buy another. Still, such attitudes don't always go unpunished.
Father! Father!
Is this your doing?
Of course not. Wolves kill. It's in their nature. Invite one into your home, it's gonna tear your throat out eventually. Same with bearers. Fed or not, they don't lack for fangs. What will folk do when they bite back, I wonder? The realm's nest two murderous bastards, and I won't mourn the loss. Here. For their help.
You don't have to.
Take it. You never know. Our paths may cross again. Till then.
An Imperial watchtower. Should be well stocked.
Wait. You're not one of us.
That's enough.
Torgo! It's over.
Too slow.
My wounds, boy!
You will pay for what you've done!
my wounds, boy!
What are you playing at, Brandon?
That's enough.
You're not welcome here.
It's not getting any fresher.
And what can I do for you? I do like a customer who knows what he wants. An excellent choice.
That's the day done then.
Thank you.
you see my Chloe? I let her out of her pen while I did my chores. But she hasn't come back yet. I think she's lost. Please, can you help me look for her?
I can't promise I'll find her, but I'll try. Describe her to me.
She's beautiful, white hair. She lets me stroke her when I'm sad. She's ever such a good girl. So quiet and kind. And she likes walking in the wheat. I know the fields are big, but she's never got lost before. Oh, she must be starving too. She hasn't eaten anything since yesterday. It is my job to feed her.
In that case, let's not keep her waiting. That's a lot of field to search. With a little luck, someone might have seen her.
Chloe always comes back. Always. But she's never been this late before.
You work these fields? I need to ask you something.
A branded. And an outsider at that, judging by the lack of manners. Why should I help you, eh? You tell me that.
Because a girl from the village asked me to find her pet. Chloe. Have you seen her?
Chloe, is it? Oh, little Lisette's plaything. Last I saw, the filthy creature was sniffing about the windmill. That girl's old enough to know she should tie her pet up when she's finished playing with it.
The windmill.
Off with you now. I won't have idle branded underfoot.
Napping on the job. I hope they don't mind the interruption. The crystal's curse.
Chloe, I was calling you. Didn't you hear me?
What?
Get up now. You've slept long enough. It's time to go home. Chloe? Why did you already turn into a rock? I only made you do a bit of magic. You knew you were my favourite. None of the other Chloes had pretty hair. It could be months before Dad gives me another one. I have to wait until they're too tired to work anymore.
Is that all she was to you? A plaything? Do you really not care that she's dead?
She's not dead. She's a rock.
That? The crystal's curse? That's just how she died. And now she's gone forever. Giving another bearer her name won't change that.
No. Don't say that.
It's true. And without that brand, she would have been just another girl. Somebody's daughter. Just like you.
Dad said bearers don't have parents.
They do. Parents that give them away. Families they'll never see again. But you became Chloe's family when you took her in. Remember that. And remember her.
I... I'm so sorry, Chloe.
Had another branded drop in the field yesterday.
How do they expect us to finish the harvest when the ones the capital sends us are already half stone?
If the people of Moor are as intolerant as Isabel says, it's no wonder the Empire never sent my unit here. Are you Bertrand? The Dame sent me.
Sounds about right. Only time I hear from her is when she wants something. Well, go on then. What is it?
One of her courtesans has gone missing, and I need to find her. A soldier who may have information on her whereabouts is rumored to have come here to meet with a trader.
Many traders stop to peddle their wares on their way to the capital, but only one's been seen quarreling with a soldier.
Is he still here?
The trader? Oh, yeah. Stubborn sod stood his ground till the soldier got tired of shouting, from what I hear. If you seek him out, keep your head down. Fact is, folks round here would sooner hang a branded than help him. And that's even with the Dame's brooch for protection.
Understood.
If you want my advice, find the merchant quick and speak to him and only him. Then march yourself and that brand of yours straight back to Northreach before the locals take up their pitchforks.
Weren't expecting any new branded until the new moon. You don't think he's a deserter, do you?
What's this? A branded? Where's your master? Must I call for a constable?
I come to you from Northreach, at the behest of the Dame. Perhaps you've heard of her.
Why, of course I have. I am the good lady's servant. What is it that she requires of me?
Rumor has it you were seen arguing with a soldier some few days ago. A soldier with a scar over his eye.
Yes, that's right. He had a comb which he claimed was an antique. Said he wanted to trade it for a newer one. But although it was an antique, it most certainly was not, as I told him. Nevertheless, he insisted that it was of great value and was quite vehement about my appraisal. I stood firm, however, and for all his bluster, he still purchased a new comb, albeit an inexpensive one.
And do you know where he went after that?
My customers aren't usually in the habit of telling me whither they are bound, but as it happens, this one did. Yonder ruins, strange as it may sound.
My thanks.
Not at all. I would do anything for the Dame. Anything. Be sure and tell her, won't you, that I was helpful, I mean, most helpful. As I told you, the soldier made no secret of his destination. He said the ruins were the perfect place for him to ask his beloved Dowsabel for her hand in marriage.
You are fortunate to have fallen into the Dame's good graces, but her influence wanes the further you stray from Northreach. Remember that, my wayward lamb.
It smells of death here, Torgo. Wolves. We can't let them get any closer to the village.
Yeah.
A man and a woman. Well, the wolves have been busy. But the blood is long dry. So it is you, Tatian.
If that's true, then the body next to hers will be Yannick's. The girl Yannick went off to see every night. He said her name was Tatian.
You. Did you follow me?
Now, why would I do that? Unless you think I'd have good reason to. But no. I was sent to find Yannick. And by the looks of things, I have.
We both found who we were searching for.
Nah, he was a jealous sod. Couldn't stand the thought of his woman with someone else. Then one day he sees her with a new comb. Thinks she's got herself a new gallant. Tells the garrison he's going to find the man and kill him. We know it's all talk, but then he disappears off to Moor for some dealings and doesn't come back.
If you mean this comb, it was a gift from the dame.
If only Yannick had bothered to ask, eh? He might not be rotting on a hill.
I think he meant to ask her something else. He stole the old comb and bought her a new one in the hope they'd wed.
Wed? Where would they have gone? Certainly not back to Northreach with a dame waiting. And we all know what happens to deserters. Tell the dame I'm sorry for her loss. When the lads come to collect Yannick's body, I'll see that Tatian is delivered to the Vale.
Is that wise?
Ah, there won't be any covering up this mess. The most we can hope for is that the dame doesn't hold it against us. Speaking of which, I saw her in Moor just now. Could you tell her what happened? Might sound better coming from you.
I need to tell Isabel. Perhaps the comb will give her something to remember Tatian by.
If it was a message that needed delivering, I could have seen to it, m'lady.
Of course you could, had it not been personal.
You are still in one piece, I see. You will be pleased to hear that your companions have arrived. They said they would meet you at a little chapel to the east of here.
Thank you, but you needn't have come all this way just to tell me. I was on my way to see you.
You found her, then? I see. My dear Tatian. It is by no means uncommon for a client to fall for a courtesan. Especially a client who's young and far from home. But rarely do such tales have happy endings.
I found this with Tatian. I believe it was yours.
Thank you for returning it. I shall see that it has a place on her pyre.
I should go.
Before you do, I have one last gift. A token of my thanks. The Vale counts among its patrons several high-ranking officers of the Imperial Army. According to one of the looser-tongued gentlemen, it would appear that the legions are planning to march south
or two mention the same thing.
But did he mention that it was all of the legions? This is no mere skirmish. Were I to guess, I'd say the Emperor planned to abandon the capital. But that couldn't possibly be true now, could it? Take care, Clive.
I will. And thank you again.
It amuses me that Cid would choose a chapel for your rendezvous. There never was a more unrepentant soul in all the realm.
Weren't expecting any new branded until the new moon.
Any trouble on the way?
None worth mentioning.
As I was telling Jill, it's worse than I thought. The capital's crawling with soldiers.
And here I am, the deserter come home.
Which is why we'll be taking the back door. Cheer up, you two. Can't think of a safer place in the Empire than it. Brothel.
Really? Doesn't seem very private.
So then, how do we proceed?
We'll be using the glass gate. Tonight, just after sunset.
Where the shards are loaded for transport. That is one of the most heavily guarded points in all of Sambrek.
But not the most, which is a start. Besides, I know a shortcut straight to the heart.
A shortcut? And how exactly did you come to know about this fatal chink in the Empire's armor?
Let's just say I may have attempted something similar before. And may have ended up running for dear life after being discovered by Bahamut, but that's not important.
Cid, if the Mother Crystals truly are the cause of the Blight...
If? You wound me, Jill.
What I'm trying to say is, if the powers that be know all of this, why do they sit idle and allow it to continue?
In case you haven't noticed, the God-fearing people of this realm and their pious leaders care for but one thing, themselves. And they'll do whatever it takes to hold on to power. The rest of us are just a means to an end. The moment you raise your voice against them, you're decried as an outlaw, clapped in irons and slung in a cell to rot.
An outlaw.
Whoever controls the crystals controls the realm. But our kind can wield magic without them. To our rulers, we must seem the most convenient of tools, and the most dangerous.
But what makes them think they have the right to use us? To leave us to die when our bodies are spent?
Does a nobleman weep for a broken mug? A torn tunic? Our fate means nothing to them. No, this isn't a battle you can win with words. Believe me, I've tried, but nothing ever gets through. The world is simply not ready to listen. So to hell with talking. If they won't give us a say, we'll decide our fates another way. You can't blame a man for wanting to bring an end to all this, can you?
I can't. But what of all the people you mean to rob of their comforts? Are you happy for them to call you outlaw?
Sid the Outlaw. Aye, that'll do me.
You might at least pretend to take this seriously.
Have a little faith, Jill. Even if you don't think much of my choice of digs. If it means my deeds will be remembered, I'll gladly play the role of villain. But first, we have a gate to crash. And once we're in, there'll be no turning back. Your best mate ready. The world won't save itself.
Seat, Clive. I'll fetch you a bowl of brown.
Welcome to the family. Again.
Fancy giving us a hand? Quick look.
Seen enough?
Clive, was it?
I heard Otto barking at his lot earlier.
Well? So, will it be? And?
There are not nearly enough men here.
Well, it's fortunate the city guard doesn't take sentry assignment as seriously as you do. This bodes well.
Won't be a first. This may not be such a terrible plan after all.
And what exactly is that supposed to mean?
Only that your last secret shortcut was nowhere near as secret as you claimed.
Yeah, but that's half the fun of it. Life's too short for perfect plans. You want a plan that'll keep you on your toes, stop you growing old and complacent.
Worked for you, has it?
Clive, my boy, even life's smallest challenges offer the opportunity to grow and to change. You must embrace these moments. Allow them to suffuse your heart with a deep sense of fulfillment.
Narrowly escaping death at the hands of an enemy is not my idea of fulfillment.
Something wrong?
Not at all. Just wondering if the two of you had finished.
Right. We make for the Mother Crystal's heart as planned. Destroy it and the whole thing should come tumbling down.
And if the passage to the Inner Sanctum is guarded?
Then we embrace the moment and use it to grow and change. Come on, this way. Try to stay out of sight.
Obviously.
Well, the passage is empty. Never stood a chance.
You're welcome.
The main tunnel.
That would be my guess. There are sentries everywhere.
Good things must come to an end. We might have a bit more company from now on.
Captain! To arms, men! Summon the cannonade! At once!
This may be the moment I was talking about earlier. What have we here? More insects come to be squashed? You will find my mortar and I only too happy to oblige. We're a talker.
Then let's shut him up. This time. Not this
to get used to that. The Kashiko, no, he was still a man. A man who drowned in ether.
It's no way for anyone to go.
Come on.
Guard duty's a death sentence in this place. Not that Sylvester cares.
Better already.
Blessing, my friends. You said being a dominant doesn't have its benefits.
Sid, this is an ether flood.
There shouldn't be one here, should there? The workers couldn't survive this.
Well, it wasn't here last time, I can tell you that. Which means we need to be quick. The ether won't hurt us, but I'd rather not find out what it's done to everyone else. To keep people out.
They were there to keep the Akashic in.
Doesn't look that far. Right. Some help.
Hold on.
I used to be.
I'll take that as a thank you.
Look on the bright side. At least you won't get lost. See, they replaced that wooden door with something a little more sturdy. On the count of three.
To two.
Ask one.
Once more.
Aye, seeing as you're trying now. As if that was going to keep us out. Mother Crystal's just up ahead.
Is it? I can't see a thing.
Well, unless someone's moved it. There's no one about.
I knew it would be big. But this...
There. That's our way into the inner sanctum. You'd think they'd have patched that up by now. Sorry state the Empire's in.
Wait. You don't mean...
Aye. My little game of hide-and-seek with Bahamut ended here. A tragic cost to this remarkable architecture. Don't blame me, he started it.
But how did he make it out alive?
Warped. You should try it.
Oh, no.
Them again.
Is there something you two want to tell them?
Maybe later. Keep your distance!
those creatures from Phoenix Gate be here in the mines?
Are the two places connected somehow?
Like all the rest.
In the Imperial Army, soldiers assigned to the Glass Gate would tell stories about something they called the Guardian.
Can't say I saw anything like that when I was last here. Then again, I can't say I made it this far.
Let's just be careful then. Where did that come from?
If I had to guess...
Poor beast. Another victim of the Flood.
Clive?
Always.
Where's he off to now? Clyde, look out!
Too slow.
Are you all right?
Fine.
The inner sanctum lies just beyond. Chances are the palace guard knows we're here. We should move. Not that any sane commander would send his men into a place awash with this much ether. Clive.
Hmm?
If this all works, and the blessing fades, things are likely to get worse for our kind before they get better. Being the last to wield ether will make our talents that much more sought after. By which I mean, hunted. I just hope, in the end, they'll see that we didn't have any other choice. That it was the only way to get us to a better place.
And here I was, thinking I was the uncertain one. Luckily, two out of three of us have faith in you.
Then it all starts here. Time to earn that menacing title. Sid the Vicious, was it? Second thoughts?
Not me.
We're with you to the end, Sid.
Then what are we waiting for?
Beautiful.
The heart of Sunbreak.
Well, that didn't work. I think we're gonna need a bigger sword.
Mine's bigger.
Thank you, Clive, but I meant that figuratively. The core's clearly made of sterner stuff. Taya's going to have a fit when she hears about this. Stand back. It's about to get cramped in here.
Clive, look.
What is that?
Sid! Without you!
heart.
Again! Where are you?
I've been here before.
Francis, I have a mockery message. Yes, the second quarter of the area will be done. Will we?
You. You again. Where are you? What do you want? Fuck. He's still alive.
Yeah!
isn't yours. Mine.
Enjoy your nap.
You're wounded.
This? It's only a scratch. All right. The hole.
We'll find you a healer.
Here. No, you won't. I know who you are, and if you think I'm gonna let you have him. Think again.
Try not to talk.
Clive, for so long, I thought I had all the answers. But then I met you, and I learned it wasn't a good death we should be fighting for, but a better life. It's all very well, a man reclaiming his fate. But if he can't choose how he meets it, what's the point? So, I made a choice.
In ashen grip, let ember glow to kindle flames anew.
Sorry, Clive. Had I arrived but a moment sooner. Do you remember me, Bob? I saw you protect them. That was very brave.
I know you're there, Ultima.
You have learned our name. What else have you learned, Phoenix?
My travels have revealed much about you and your ambitions. I know that it was you who tore me from my brother. And I know that it is his power that you seek. But know this. If you want him, you'll have to go through me.
Very well.
The breath of mine ancestors, fill these lungs that I may dispel the songs of suffering.
A disturbance.
This is getting us nowhere.
We agree. No more games, Phoenix. We are come to claim our vessel.
And I said no.
Flames are nothing. You will know what it is to burn.
Yours is a fleeting form. I'm not fool enough to think I can harm you. But to protect my brother, I don't have to.
These are not flames of destruction.
Have you forgotten already who I am? Now. Fiend. Oh.
You heard me! She must be here. Must! Fail Lord Cook again! Find Sid! We're all fucking dead!
Sid, help us!
Where is he? You'll do!
Bastard!
Gab! We've got to go!
Not without this!
Sid is not among the dead.
Shall I send a Stolas?
That won't be necessary.
The finest silks from the master weavers of Randalar.
Come, feel its softness.
Jobbo steaks, jobbo sausage, all from Greensfed farm birds. None of the old courses you'll find elsewhere. Here, take a bite.
I've got peppers and peas, beans and beets. If it goes in a pot, I've got the lot.
Formatives, curatives, restoratives, uncut,
look all you like, sir.
Poultices.
It's all fresh. Pick this very morning.
Restoratives, unguents, ointments, poultices, palmatives, curatives, restoratives. Unguents, ointments, poultices.
Might I interest you in a potion, m'lady? Perhaps a soothing salve to ease the aches of the road?
I'm sorry. I wish you well, but may the mothers guide you.
Calmatives, curatives, restoratives. Unguents, ointments, poultices. Calmatives, curatives, restoratives.
Good to see you, Sid. What have we learned? The bearers are locked up in an old courthouse on the edge of town. And I hardly need tell you who is there to make sure they stay that way.
Kupka's private guard.
It's a trap. And not a very good one at that.
Another? What does he hope to gain from this?
I'll have the captives free before nightfall.
You do nothing of the sort. Our comrades didn't give their lives for you to get your throat slit in a god's forsaken slum.
So those in the courthouse should be left to suffer.
That's not what I said. I simply meant it doesn't have to be you who frees them. You're as stubborn as the old Sid was. Just don't say I didn't warn you. You're Sid now, And if anything happens to him, we're finished.
Please, we don't know anything. You have to believe us. We'd help you if we could.
But you're helping us already.
Forgive him, my lord. He did not mean to offend.
Quiet, you!
No sign of Hugo.
I'll wager he thinks as highly of his minions' traps as we do.
Then this should be easy.
Don't hurt us. I beg of you.
Quiet means quiet, branded scum.
It's going to be all right. I'm here to even the odds. Any objections?
It's him! The outlaw! Sit here!
Should we?
Come on! Summon the others!
Safe.
Enough of this!
Let him play with the kitten!
They've brought a pet.
You'll pay for what you've done, Sid.
Those things are fast.
We'll have to be faster.
With this.
They'll tell Hugo.
Let them. There's been more than enough bloodshed for one day.
Murderer. All of our friends are dead because of you. Do you hear me? They used us as bait. Bait to lure you out of your stinking hole, all because you couldn't just let things be.
What are you even doing here? We never asked to be saved. Did you think we'd thank you? They'll never forgive us. We're all marked now.
For 5 years, we fought to secure a better life for our kind. To see that we are treated as equals. Do you not want that?
What we want is to be left alone. Every time you show your faces, it is we who suffer.
It's all right. I'm sorry.
Just leave us be. This is our home, and this is where we'll stay.
C. Sid told us this wouldn't be easy. They'll come round.
If you say so.
We should go. That night 5 years ago, we destroyed what for many was a symbol of hope, for a reason they'll never know. We cannot blame them for thinking us the cause of their misery. Though it's to give them a better tomorrow, they see only that we've made their lives harder today. Yet the boil must be lanced if it is to heal.
I can't help but wonder if we've made the right choice.
When Sid said that he wanted to create a world where we were free, free to choose our own path. I honestly don't think it mattered to him if that choice was right or wrong. Only that it was our own.
I miss him.
A world where we can live and die as equals. That's what he wanted. What we want. And that's why I bear his name. It's why we've all chosen to bear his legacy. And I'm not going to let anything stand in our way.
Ride's over, lovebirds. Home sweet home. Otto was asking after you. Let's go and see him.
Never a dull moment.
Last I saw, he was in the mess, as always.
Welcome back, Sid.
Finish with that log so we can call it a morning.
Almost done.
Again? We've seen schoolboys swing harder.
Otto will want to know what happened in Cosnes. I expect he'll be in the mess. Otto will want to know what happened in Cosnes. I expect he'll be in the mess.
Hey,
did.
Stay in London this time.
Hither yon dance autumn winds atop the rotten pier. Of Sid's return the faithful sing across the blighted mere. As hither yon dance autumn winds atop
the... Shelves are closed. The sign outside should have told you. Yeah, the sign outside should have told you.
But there's no sign.
Have we any more knuckle pies?
Oh, sadly not. Molly used the last of the chocobo in the stew.
Well, I should be getting back to it. Unless you'd rather...
What can I get you, Sid?
No, perhaps I should just have Blackthorn make me a new one.
Am I getting on? About as well as you'd expect of a barmaid pouring sour ale for penniless outlaws in the middle of the Deadlands. And it'd be worse than that if Molly here didn't make the best stew this side of Stone here, even if it is mostly just yesterday's leavings. Don't tell her you heard that from me, though. Coming right up. Don't be a stranger, Sid.
Is it business or pleasure?
Well, you won't hear me complaining. The only drawback... Still... I remember it like it was yesterday.
You're our leader now, Clive. Coin purse weighing you down? Finished, are you?
Clive, you're back. You didn't happen to run out of potions while you're away, did you? We've a fine selection of tonics and tinctures. Oh, perhaps you'd be interested in some new gear.
Told me you could fire a forge without a crystal or a bearer before I came here, I'd have taken you for a madman. But no, here it is.
The secret's in the bellows, you know.
They're Master Sid's own design. The other Master Sid.
Back are ya? Things here ain't too bad. Nah. You've forgotten already. Because I haven't. Still. What do you want? No scratches, right? Don't waste my time. You ain't got the stuff. Bring me the materials, and I'll think about it. You can thank me later. And how am I meant to do that, then? Bad, if I do say so myself. Yeah, that should do ya. Anything else?
Clive, is everything all right? War is brewing. I can feel it.
All operations are suspended until further notice.
Yes, Captain.
I'll let the others know.
Have you finished sorting those reports yet?
Finished? I ain't started. Been busy enough with my own work.
You're pulling my leg, aren't you? Otto's gonna skin me alive.
Ah, there you are, Clive. Word of your adventures arrived this morning.
Victor sends his thanks.
I doubt Kupka will miss the fools he sent to catch me. Not a single one of the bearers we saved showed any interest in coming with us. No one seems keen to join hands with an outlaw. Any news while we were away?
None worth mentioning. Gav's still off keeping an eye on the Republican army. Should be back any day now.
Understood. If anyone needs me, I'll be in the map room.
Still can't work that one out. There must be better places than the hull of a gutted airship to bury your nose in a book.
Yet this is where she's chosen to be. And I'm sure she has her reasons.
I learned something new. You'll be the first to know. Now off you go.
Lady Tyre is performing a delicate operation and must not be disturbed. I'll let her know you called.
No one works longer or harder than our Otto. You can scour the whole of Storm and Ash, and you won't find a better man.
Escape from the slave markets. How'd you manage that?
I had some help, but it was mostly luck. The others weren't so lucky.
Trust I'm not intruding.
Back from your mission? I'm beginning to think your habit of surviving cannot be attributed to luck alone.
One might say the same of you, Vivian Ninetales.
I'll have you know that only 4 attempts have been made on my life, and none was especially memorable. So, to what do I owe the honor? Could it be that you've come for one of my lessons?
Is that so hard to believe?
Very well, then. Shall we start with the state of the realm? To absolutely no one's surprise, she finds herself at the mercy of armies and outlaws. Well, mostly armies. Though that's not for want of trying, is it, Clive? But the real question is, how did we get here? Long though Sambrek's dominion over northeastern Storm has endured, recent days have seen the Blight wrest ever more land from her grasp. For which reason, she has continued to wage war on her rival across the strait, hoping to claim less blackened pastures. But Odin would sooner pawn his sword than Walud relinquish Ash. And the Empire pays dearly for every blade of grass bent beneath Sambrequois boots. Little wonder, then, that Sylvester set his sights on the crystalline dominion, an altogether easier target, possessed of no less ether. It was 5 years ago, while you were busying yourself with the destruction of Drake's Head, that the Empire made its move, subjugating its theretofore neutral neighbor, a nation which could legitimately claim to be the center of the world. Certainly, there is no better place to stage an army. From there, the Holy Empire's reach spans the Twins. The non-aggression treaty was the only thing keeping them in check. But if they truly broke the pact without provocation, it is only a matter of time before others reply in kind. The Holy Empire, the Dalmechian Republic, the Kingdom of Walud, and of course, our friends in Yaran. Who will be left standing, I wonder, when the last drop of blood is spilled?
You were born in Twinside. Do not fear for your home.
Oh, dark clouds are wont to gather over the Dominion. Yet in spite of it all, she has ever endured. And when the storm has passed, I am confident she will remain. Now, as to the matter of payment for today's lesson, complete a simple errand for me and we shall consider ourselves even.
Even? Right.
Return this volume to old Tomes in the shelves. Tell him it was adequate.
I suppose it wouldn't hurt to visit our resident historian.
Here for another of my lectures. One would think. I admit. A far more reputable fellowship. My beloved homeland. Or at least, it was. How may I help you today? The details here. Here you are. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
Said the hideaway is built inside an airship. Said it was called the Invincible.
Lawsman Harpocrates.
Now that is a name I have not heard for a long time. So long, in fact, I had half forgotten it was mine. Welcome home, Clive. You were missed. As always.
I believe this belongs to you. Vivian asked me to return it.
Ready? Our resident scholar devours books faster than young Tet does lemon tarts. Would that I could do the same. But alas, I no longer possess the necessary constitution for such indulgence, either in words or tarts. That said, I have continued my search for mention of the creature you encountered at Drake's Head. But without access to the great libraries of Oriflam or the Dominion, I regret that I have been able to find little and less. I am sorry.
Please, don't apologize. I'll send word to our associates. See if they can't furnish you with more books.
I fear it is not more books that I require, but the right ones. Mayhap we look in the wrong places. There are still libraries to the north.
I'll see what I can do.
You are too kind. There are not many in this world who would indulge the whims of a tired old historian.
Not too tired to go filching coupon nuts, though. Always got a pocket for him. Nicks him off the Moogle.
Hush now. We all know there's no such thing as Moogles.
The twins seem well.
Aye. Yet they laugh far too little for one so young. The loss of their parents weighs heavy on them, however well they hide it. Titan took much from us that night, from some more than others, and the wounds that remain, they are not quick to heal.
Which is why we must give them all the time they need.
That we must. Just as I must give you the time you need to recuperate. Good day, Clive.
Good day. Gav will be back soon. I should get some rest while I can.
My knowledge is yours. Look around you. Still. Why? It has been difficult, certainly. Had you not led us here, I still remember. Thank goodness they did. I have compiled some new entries, if you would like to see them. I have quite the find for you today. Wish to study the tomes? Did you learn everything you needed?
Not back a blink, and you're already off solving everyone's problems. It looks good, Clive. Goes well with the scowl.
I'd had that brand for so long. I'd forgotten what life was like without it. What it was like to be myself. And it's all thanks to you, Talia.
The scalpel did most of the work. Ah, before I forget, a rider was here with a letter from Gav. Otto left it on your desk.
Otto stole us? All right, I'll have a look.
And then you get some rest.
What could Gav have thought worthy of a letter?
Here, some curio root tea for the pain.
As a rule, Gav only resorts to letter writing when there's trouble. That, or he's misplaced the stolas. Let's hope this time's the exception.
Charlie says I can't go and play until I finish my sums.
Well, then hurry up and finish them! We need 3 for curling geese.
Ah, Sid. We were just about to start our next lesson. You're welcome to join us. But be warned, I tolerate absolutely no tomfoolery.
Can't catch a wink with all the clamor in the hall. The atrium's quiet this time of day.
Sid, what's the special occasion?
You're welcome to join us for a spell, if you think Jill won't mind.
Osman says I can borrow as many books as I can carry. This was all I could carry.
Go on. Eat up. You won't grow fat pecking at hay.
What's the matter, Sid? You look as pale as the day your predecessor slung you in the cell next to mine. About to have another fit, are you? Of course you aren't. You're a changed man now. We both are.
Thank you.
Where did I put that sack of lime? Sack of lime.
That they bloomed at all is a blessing in itself.
From the lake water and renders it clear. You'll have to ask Mid if you want to know how it works, though.
Much was lost when the first hideaway fell. Colleagues and friends. Years of hard work, but we did not let that loss defeat us. And our work will not be in vain. No. The spirits of our fallen comrades live on in every leaf and limb you see here.
To meet you. I can keep him, can I? Can I?
Nearly half the crates were lost to bandits.
But half weren't, and their contents will see us through the season.
I bought my wife.
Otto was here earlier with a letter from Gav. He left it on your desk. What does Gav have to say?
The Republican army is on the march, leaving Randalar in Hugo Kupka's charge. With him and his men occupied with the defense of the capital, they're less likely to trouble us.
Good news, then.
It's more than that. This is our chance. The one we've been waiting for.
But look how far we've come. All that we have here, our friends, the hideaway, are they not cause for joy?
5 years. 5 long years. If I could only command this power I've been granted, we might have achieved so much more. But each time I reach for it, it's like something is holding me back.
Summoning an icon exacts a price not easily paid. Your body knows this only too well. It's merely trying to save you from yourself.
And every burden I cannot bear falls to you.
This mission of ours has made me question everything I thought I knew. But one thing has become abundantly clear. The crystals take more than they give. In exchange for momentary comfort, we must endure a lifetime of pain, war after war, loss upon loss. And now? Now they rob us of our very homes, leaving naught but dust and ash. But you're trying to change that. We are trying to change that. And to me, that's no burden.
I know, but...
Try not to forget. We're only here because Joshua gave us a second chance. It would be a pity to waste such a precious gift.
He did. He was there. It wasn't an illusion. I heard him call out to Ultima. If Joshua is still alive, he'll be looking for that thing.
Do you think he will ever come back?
I know he will. And we must be ready when he does. To a world without Mother Crystals. Sid.
So the North is lost.
I knew that the Blight spread ever more swiftly, Your Grace. But this is far, far worse than any could have imagined.
It is only a matter of time before the Twins are no more. The world marches ever closer to its end, and here we chase shadows. Tell me, brother. Are our efforts in vain?
Master Clive, a moment, if you... My apologies, I didn't mean to... intrude.
Not at all. We were just discussing strategy.
Speak freely, Otto.
It's Martha, from the inn. She's gone missing. Anyway, I'll be in the mess when you've finished.
Very well.
What
would make Martha leave the rest.
If something has happened to Martha, we need to speak with Otto.